Ma'am, this topic is our home planet, the Earth. It was only when Earth was caught on a single photograph frame did we realize that our planet was a unique planet in the entire solar system. The big round ball whirls in the dark with the stars studded expanse like a blue jewel. The blueness is because of the presence of water. The color is stark in contrast to the other planets, which are lifeless and barren. Let us first start with a few basics. 71% of the Earth's surface is covered with water, and the rest makes up the land. The most of the water is contained in seas and oceans. Speaking of which, let's move on to the oceans. There are 5 major oceans: the Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Arctic, and Antarctic oceans, out of which the Pacific Ocean is the largest of them all. But where does all this water come from? Rain, of course. Clouds bring rain and ensure that we get a steady supply of water. Other than water, let's move on to land. The 7 continents make up a major part of the land. They are Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, and Antarctica, from which Asia is the largest of them all. Other than land and water, there is also a layer of air known as the atmosphere that blankets the Earth and does not let the harmful rays of the sun reach the Earth. The atmosphere is a mixture of various kinds of gases. It consists of 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and the remaining 1% of the other gases like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and others. And carbon dioxide is necessary for the process of photosynthesis in plants, and oxygen is necessary for the survival of living beings and living humans and animals. Now, getting back to Earth, planet Earth is one of the 8 planets of the solar system. The solar system actually has 9 planets, which are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. But Pluto in 2006 was known as a dwarf planet, and since then it's not counted as a planet or even considered as a planet. But it's considered as a dwarf planet instead. Now, getting back to Earth, it is a unique planet in the entire solar system. Do you know what makes it unique? It's because it's the only planet that is known to support life. And also it is at just the right distance from the sun, and also has all the conditions suitable that are needed to support life on the planet. It is the 5th largest planet after Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and it's the 3rd planet from the sun after Mercury and Venus. Earth is a unique planet in the entire solar system. Have you ever wondered how old the Earth really is, or how the Earth was actually formed? Well, here's your answer. This is your lucky day because you get the answer. Planet Earth is 4,600 million years old, and that was around the same time when the other planets of the solar system were formed out of a big cloud of gas and dust. At the center of the cloud, nuclear reactions began to take place that formed the sun. Because of its huge size, it exerted gravitational force around its surrounding fragments. Some of the fragments collided against each other, while the others clumped together to form the 9 planets of the solar system, including Pluto, that is. Scientists have been able to tell when exactly the Earth was formed by studying meteors that have reached the asteroid belt. The meteor remains have dated back to 4,600 million years ago, and that was when the solar system was formed. The universe was formed 13.7 billion years ago, and at the age of 4,600 million years, the solar system is relatively younger. Though no one knows for sure how the Earth was formed, many astronomers and scientists believe that the Earth was formed by the spinning of large clouds of dust and gas left after the birth of the sun. Here is the process of how the earth was formed. Hot clouds of dust and gas circled the forming sun, and then a cloud of dust clumps together and whirls around the center of the solar system. The forming earth is bombarded with excess gas and dust blown off by the sun. Then the earth slowly starts to cool down and volcanoes throw gases, forming the clouds. The clouds bring rain, forming the seas, oceans and other water bodies. And because of the presence of water, life started evolving on earth. And after millions and millions of years of evaluating, the earth has become a place that we know today. In the beginning, when the earth was newly formed, it exerted gravitational force because of its huge size. And when gravity acted upon it, the force of gravity forced the earth to take the shape of a sphere. When gravity acted upon it further, the planet compressed and the constituents changed into molten state. When the earth was just an infant, it was made up of entirely molten material. And when the earth slowly started to cool down, the heavier metals sank to the core while lighter metals stayed afloat. The iron and metal sank to the core and formed the iron-rich core, and also while the silica-rich magma stayed afloat. The earth acts as a giant magnet because of its magnetic field. In the outer core, it usually keeps boiling and churning and also keeps moving all the time, and this produces electricity. This makes Earth act as a giant magnet. The Earth's magnetic field extends far into space. Its magnetic field protects it from charged atomic particles from the sun in the form of solar wind. However, the particles enter the Earth through the poles, the North Pole and the South Pole. This creates a visual spectacular shimmering of lights in the North Pole, known as the Northern Lights, also called the Aurora Borealis, and in the South Pole, known as the Southern Lights, also called the Aurora Australis. Now, little did we know that all the time while we were spending our whole life on the Earth's surface, there is a whole different world inside the Earth. The Earth is made up of four layers: the crust, mantle, inner core, and the outer core. Natural phenomena like volcanoes and also earthquakes help us understand a lot about the Earth's inside the Earth. The Earth is, as I told you, is made up of four layers. Now, let us know about them a little bit more deeper. The crust. If the Earth was reduced to the size of an apple, the crust would be like its peel. It has an average thickness of 40 kilometers, and it's the thickest under the continents, which is 70 kilometers, and the thinnest under the oceans, which is just 8 kilometers. The oxygen, aluminium, and other components make up the crust. And next comes another layer, which is known as the morphic continuity. And I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing this wrong because it's a really hard spelling. So the crust and the mantle are divided by a boundary known as the morphic continuity. It is named after a Korean scientist. Next comes the mantle. The upper layer of the mantle is just like the Earth's crust. So the scientists group the crust and the upper layer of the mantle together and call it lithosphere. While the lower layer of the mantle is entirely molten rock. The temperature varies between 2000 degrees Celsius and 4000 degrees Celsius. Next comes the outer core. This outer core is the only layer that is made up of entirely liquid. It is made out of entirely molten rock, and the temperature of this hot layer is 4000 degrees Celsius and to 5500 degrees Celsius. And also the outer core is mainly made up of iron with a small amount of nickel. Next comes the inner core. The inner core is at a temperature of 7500 degrees Celsius, and even at such a hot temperature, the inner core is still a hard ball of iron and nickel. Metals do not remain solid at such great temperatures, but the pressure of the above layers is so immense that the metals in the inner core do not melt. So as I told you, the temperature of this extremely hot layer is 7500 degrees Celsius. And the reason this is made up of metal is because in the beginning the heavier metals sank to the core. So it's made up of mostly iron and nickel. These are the chief elements of the outer core. Planet Earth is our home, but it is just a small little speck in the universe, which contains about 100 billion galaxies, and each galaxy contains about 200 billion stars, and other stars in the universe may also have solar systems. That's it for today. Until next time, I'm Aradhya. I'll see you in the next video.